When I think about some of my favorite games this generation, I tend to think about what exactly made them special. And more often than not, I find that the answer usually resides in small things that are not really highlighted in the marketing, but actually complete the world and the immersion that the developers are trying to sell. And with a game as huge as Cyberpunk 2077, it's fairly common that we focus on big highlights such as the size of the map, variety of vehicles and other gear, and even visuals. However, the world only ever truly comes alive when it has small details that make you realize that it is in fact a working, breathing world that functions on its own while also allowing you to take a part in it. And it seems like Cyberpunk 2077 definitely has taken these things into account. Which leads us to this video. Here are some small details that I found to be incredibly surprising that add some nice immersion to the world of Cyberpunk 2077. But before that,
feeling today, because I feel amazing.
With any open world RPG that thrives on immersion, it's absolutely essential for it to have activities that actually make you feel like you're participating in the world. One of the ways game developers have done this is by adding the option to drink or eat at bars and restaurants that you prefer. And so far, the best example of this would have been Red Dead Redemption 2. Yet Cyberpunk 2077, with its mandatory first-person camera perspective, seems to be even more impressive. But aside from that, the setup of a scene like this and world itself actually plays a huge role as well, since the atmosphere adds a ton of immersion. And with what we saw in the postcards from Night City trailer, it seems like CDPR have absolutely knocked it out of the park with this aspect of the game, as you can visit bars and have drinks, or have some meatballs on the streets with Jackie and Johnny Silverhand. Now, Johnny Silverhand himself isn't actually a small detail of the game. In fact, I actually believe that Cyberpunk 2077's story is equally about him as much as it is about we. But that's a topic for another video. Let's get back to why Johnny Silverhand is actually on this list. Throughout the game, Johnny Silverhand will be with you. And I mean that literally. You'll actually see him pop up in various circumstances, and in fact, by the looks of it, he'll even be present when you're drinking, eating or fornicating. While we don't know about the fornicating part, we have actually seen footage of Johnny judging us when we try out new clothes or food. This is such a small thing, but I love how CDPR went the extra mile to incorporate him in everything you do, since somewhere around the start of the game, V and Silverhand basically share the same body because of the chip. It's pretty fascinating, and I would say it's creepy as well, but since Silverhand is played by Keanu Reeves, it's just wholesome instead. Now, the next thing on this list isn't exactly a small detail, but there's tons of little stuff about the NPCs that make them pop out in my eyes. First of which are the different preferences and the reactions people have to your choices, because unlike other open world games, interactable NPCs actually react to your choices and act accordingly. And that goes from all the way from something as small as your genitals to something narrative changing like the different life paths. Interactable NPCs in this game actually have a purpose, goal, and personality outside of contributing to the main character's adventure, and it's something that I appreciate a lot. However, non-interactable NPCs in this game should also turn out fine and look unique, unlike CDPR's last game, The Witcher 3, where I swear half the people in the town were twins to the other half. That said though, when CDPR creates an interactable NPC, they create them with love, passion, and care, and I can't wait to meet these characters in-game. But the NPCs aren't the only thing that CDPR makes with passion. The worlds they create always have this charm to it, like small hidden quests and secrets, and that aspect of the world has most definitely carried over to Cyberpunk 2077. The map itself is actually quite different from The Witcher 3's, since they have vastly different themes and setting, where the map in The Witcher 3 was quite open with large forests and swamps in between settlements. In Cyberpunk 2077, it is much more condensed and tightly packed, which allows developers to hide in some nice little secrets, such as a hidden elevator to allow for some nice shortcuts in vertical exploration, or alleyways that you will discover when you explore the world. Another thing you might discover are these little mini stories you can find while exploring the world that will flesh out the lore of Cyberpunk or give some other kind of special reward. And what's cool about that is that it might even be a famous personality you know that can give you these quests. Now that we have already talked about the world and the consequences that your choices will have, let's talk about the street cred system, because I honestly haven't seen it discussed much and because I think it is a fantastic system. The way that Street Cred works is that it allows you access to better, higher-end weapons and mods while also changing how you are perceived in the world, since a higher Street Cred means that you are climbing the mercenary rank and all you would have to do after that is get killed to have a drink named after you in the afterlife. Not heaven, the club afterlife where mercs hang out. But if getting killed isn't your cup of tea, then I'm sure you'll need to hit the road quick to get away from any compromising situations, and that's exactly why any car that you own will come equipped with a self-driving feature which will allow it to drive itself to your location. But if you don't own a vehicle, then you might just have to get one of the self-driving taxis instead. I would have preferred an actual person driving the taxi because it would have given an opportunity to pass the time while talking to the driver, but I guess listening to the amazing soundtrack of Cyberpunk 2077 doesn't sound too bad either. And with that, I think I've talked about all the little things that I'm looking forward to in Cyberpunk 2077. But let me know what you guys are excited about down in the comments below. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share the channel if you guys enjoyed the video. And I'll be back again with another video soon. Take care and stay safe.